the siyah, which is the will, Shia say it is impossible that the Prophet didn't leave a will. They argue from the Quran. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, many ayahs, first, kutib alaykum siyah, fasting has been ordained for you. It becomes, as my Sunni brothers and sisters would say, fard, as Shia brothers and sisters would say, wajib. Same thing. إن الصلاة كانت على المؤمنين كتابا موقوتا. Salah is a timely or a timed obligation on mu'mineen. Ordained. كتاب موقوتا. Ordained. كتاب. كتب عليكم القصاص. كتب عليكم القتال. There are many كتب. And every time there's كتب, when it comes to a ritual, it becomes fard. By the same token, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, كتب عليكم. إذا حضر أحدكم الموت إن ترك خيرا الوصية. It has been ordained upon you that if death shall become any of you, that if you leave any good, and I'm going to come back to this word, خيرا, that you have to leave a will. Now the best thing that we can do is explain the Quran by the Quran. خيرا. قالوا ماذا أنزل ربكم؟ قالوا خيرا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talks about the mu'mineen. Being asked, what did your Lord reveal? They say khayra, the same word. And that's the Quran. Scholars say that this khayr can be a dollar, or it can be Islam. It can be the Quran. How could the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam take such a fard and toss it around? It's impossible. Now, I know there are some learned Sunni brothers and sisters here who know what the rebuttal for that is. And they say this ayah was abrogated. It was nusikhat, this ayah. I can tell you, brothers and sisters, the vast majority of Sunni brothers and sisters do not believe that narrations abrogate ayat. Narrations do not abrogate the Quran. Quran only abrogates the Quran. There is not an ayah in the Quran that abrogates this ayah. In fact, there are a lot of ayat that talk about wasiyah that nobody says that they were abrogated. And for lack of time, I'm not going to mention anything. Look, brothers and sisters, Shia brothers and sisters, Sunni brothers and sisters, all Muslims. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, after Hajjat al-Wada', is traveling back out of Mecca. And alhamdulillah, I know many of you have traveled to Mecca and Medina, and you know how hot it is. It is extremely hot. You cannot touch the ground with your bare feet. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says about the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَاكَ إِلَّا رَحْمَةً لِلْعَالَمِينَ, that we have not sent you but as mercy for mankind. Talks about how merciful He is with the mu'mineen. He loves the mu'mineen. فَبِمَا رَحْمَةٍ لِنْتَ لَهُمْ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that the Prophet is soft with the mu'mineen. He's gentle with the mu'mineen. Listen to this. This is found in all books, Shias and Sunnis. This is what I'm going to tell you. The event right now is narrated by 33 companions. 33 companions who authenticated this, and it's a hadith mutawatir, this story that I'm going to tell you. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sends Jibreel alayhi salam to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and says to him, Ya ayyuhar rasul, please pay attention to every word. Ya ayyuhar rasul, balligh ma unzila ilayka min rabbik, wa in lam taf'al, فَمَا بَلَّغْتَ رِسَالَتَهُ وَاللَّهُ يَعْصِمُكَ مِنَ النَّاسِ. First, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, O messenger. Allah uses the word Rasul because that is the job of the Prophet. You know, Prophet and Rasul. Prophet is more general, Rasul is akhas. So he tells him specifically that you are a Rasul, you are my messenger. بَلِّغْ مَا أُنزِلَ إِلَيْكَ مِنْ رَبِّكَ. Convey what has been sent to you from your Lord. وَإِن لَمْ تَفْعَلْ, if you do not do that, فَمَا بَلَّغْتَ رِسَالَتَهُ, your message, everything that you have done in the past hasn't been delivered. Brothers and sisters, this event happened in Hajjat Khutbat al-Wada'. Hajjat al-Wada' happened after the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam fought 83 battles plus 5 what they call ghazawat, istitla'iyya, where he would go and discover. 88 battles. After the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam explained to us salah, so hajj, after he was coming back from hajj, has explained to us khums, has explained to us the rules of nikah, talaq, wafat, everything. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells him, convey what I have sent to you, otherwise you haven't delivered anything. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives us a hint of what this is that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was afraid to deliver. وَاللَّهُ يَعْصِمُكَ مِنَ النَّاسِ. It is something that people will not like. But Allah gives a guarantee to the Prophet that He will protect him. The Prophet gathers all the Muslims, 112,000, 112,000 who were riding camels, horses for the lucky ones, donkeys for the least lucky ones, and walking for the least lucky ones, doesn't come back. Come back to a desert by a spring that's called Ghadir al-Khum. Now I beg you to go and read how the Prophet ﷺ delivers the story.